This video, I would like to introduce general process of my trick for making animation of a robot palletizing system, done on FreeCAD. FreeCAD version was 0.20 and the assembling and animation were done on the assembly for workbench. Now, this robot is palletizing boxes on a pallet. From left side, boxes are coming on the conveyor. The front box arriving waiting deck, stops there and waits for the robot. The robot picks the box on the waiting deck, moves it and accumulates on the pallet in order. Totally 120 boxes, composed of 6 layers with 5x4 boxes for each layer, are accumulated on the pallet. Dimension of each box is 200x300mm, and 160mm in height. For this animation, I divided these movements into 5 segments. That are, movement of incoming boxes, movement of waiting box, movement of robot arm, movement of the box transported from the waiting deck to the pallet, and movement of boxes accumulated on the pallet. This is the movement of incoming boxes only. And this is the movement of waiting box only. When both movements are synchronized, it looks like one consecutive movement shown here. For the animation of the movement of these incoming boxes, an array of 6 boxes was modeled and assembled on the assembly for workbench in FreeCAD. This array of incoming boxes moves a certain distance and instantly return to its base position and move and repeat. The movement is being done along the x-axis in my 3D space, a certain equation to apply the variable to the x position is needed. For this kind of movement pattern, I started to create a basic remainder equation, that is variables %20. The graph drawn by this basic equation imitates this kind of movement pattern. Here, as the variable increases to a certain point, the dependent value increases. And the variable passing that point, the dependent value returns instantly to its base value, and repeat. We can apply this equation to the x position of incoming boxes array. Horizontal axis is to represent the variable in the animation window of assembly for workbench, and vertical axis is to represent distance from a certain base position. Finally, by modifying this basic equation, I created a new equation for the incoming boxes to be fit in my 3D space dimension, and for the timing with other parts by shifting this graph along the x-axis. On the other hand, the waiting box moves from its base position to the waiting deck, and stops and waits there for a while, and instantly returns back to its base position, and repeat. To imitate this kind of movement pattern, I created this special equation as shown here. And then, for applying to the x position of the waiting box in the assembly, I modified this equation to be fit in my 3D space dimension and for the timing with other parts by shifting this graph along the x-axis. For the sketch and modeling of the robot arm, first I designated 2 datum points, one for the hand knuckle position of this robot, and the other for the main shoulder knuckle position, above the green robot base. And then, I designated 1 datum plane based on these 2 datum points and z-axis. And on this datum plane, I made the sketch of robot arm. The X, Y, and Z positions of this robot arm move simultaneously. Animation is done by applying the variable to each X, Y, and Z position of the datum point at hand knuckle. In this case, the initial start position of this hand knuckle is always the same, but the destination position where each box is loaded on the pallet is changing. For this purpose, I created 2 equations, one for the reciprocating movement, and one for the destination position change in every box. This equation and its graph shown here, is for the reciprocating movement. Seeing this graph, we can assume, as the variable increases, the robot hand waits for a while at the beginning, and then moves for a certain distance, and then waits there for a while, and then returns to its base position, and repeat. This second equation with its graph shown here, is for the decreasing x position in every box, repeating in every column. It shows, as the variable increases, the dependent value jumps down to a different level. We can set 5 different levels for 5 boxes in one column. By multiplying previous two equations, I created a new equation. And its graph pattern shows the destination x position is changed for each box, in every 5 boxes. And then, I created this modified equation to be fit in my 3D space dimension, and timing with other parts. Instead x position changes in every box, y position changes in every column, the changing period is 5 times longer than x position, because there are 5 boxes in one column. This equation and its graph shown here, is the same that for the reciprocating movement of the robot arm. This equation with its graph shown here, is created for the decreasing y position in every column, repeating in every layer. Again here, a new graph of the equation obtained by multiplying previous two equations, shows a suitable movement pattern for the y position of the hand knuckle. And then, I modified this equation to be applied to y position of hand knuckle to fit in my 3D space dimension and timing with other parts. For the z position of the hand knuckle, the concept for reciprocating movement is the same, except the changing period is much longer, 20 times than that of x position, because it changes in every 20 boxes in one layer. The equation, for the reciprocating movement pattern of hand knuckle, is the same. This equation with its graph shown here is for the increasing z position in every layer on the palette. This graph is drawn from the new equation, obtained by multiplying previous two equations. The graph shown in downside is the magnified view of second and third layer to show its detail. In this z position, we need one more equation, which correspond to the up-down movement of the robot hand, to pick the box and load it on the palette. For this purpose, I created a new equation. Seeing its graph, we can assume, as the variable increases, the robot hand z position decreases for a certain distance, and return to its base position for a certain time, and then stops for a while and repeat. With this equation, the robot hand can move up and down, while its x and y position remains at the same position during picking and loading a box, and the robot hand to stop while the robot arm is moving from the base position to destination position. Finally, I created a new equation, by adding this equation to the previous multiplied equation for z position of the hand knuckle, and by modifying to fit in my 3D space dimensions and for the timing with the other parts. Now, we need the animation of the moving box, which is transported from the waiting deck to the pallet, by the robot hand. Because it follows the robot hand, during being moved from the waiting deck to the pallet, we can only attach it to the robot hand, in the assembly. But, while the robot arm is returning from the pallet, there should be no box at the robot hand. During this returning time, I hide it under the floor, and this box instantly appears on the waiting deck, at the time when the robot hand picks it. For this kind of movement pattern, I created a new basic equation shown here. Its graph pattern is suitable to be applied on the Z position, for hiding the moving box under the floor while the robot hand is returning, from the destination position. This new equation, was created by modifying the basic equation to fit in my 3D space dimension, and timing with the other parts. Lastly, we need the animation of accumulating 120 boxes one by one on the palette. I modeled 20 arrays of boxes. In each array, 6 boxes are vertically aligned. These arrays are also hidden beneath the palette at the beginning. And move upward, to be appeared one by one sequentially along Z axis. For this movement pattern, I created this basic equation. Seeing its graph, it can be applied for the box array to jump one step upward at the time when the robot hand put a box there, and stops there until next step, and repeat. I modified this equation to be fit in my 3D space dimension, and for the timing with the other parts for each box array. These are the applied equations for the Z position of each box array, the only difference in these arrays is the delay time for the sequential upward movements. Finally, I applied all the equations in the assembly for workbench, and got the full animation. It took 12 hours to fully animate and record the screen, from the first box to the last 120th box, because of many equations and my PC capability. I edited the recorded video to be played with increased speed. Thanks for watching.